As a result, your heart rate quickens, increasing the blood flow to your muscles. Your breathing becomes more rapid, allowing more oxygen to reach the muscles needed in this situation. Your pupils dilate and muscles tense. Even the tiny muscles attached to each hair on your skin tense, forcing the hairs to stand on end. I'm sure this is a sensation you are familiar with. Finally, non-essential systems such as digestion are shut down. Your focus is directed totally on the threat. In a matter of seconds, you are primed and ready to either fight your potential attacker or turn and flee. Of course, this is an extreme example, and the response is perfect to survive the ordeal. Frustratingly, though, our minds struggle to distinguish between something life-threatening and something just a bit out of the ordinary. For instance, when you are going for that job interview, your body responds in much the same way. The feeling of restlessness, elevated heart rate and sick feeling in your stomach. Rather than trying to remain calm by subduing these feelings and pretending that everything is fine, you can use the fear response to your advantage. The fear response acts remarkably like that of excitement. The same hormones are released, and you may experience the same symptoms, but you interpret them in a completely different way. If you are going to see your favourite band, you are probably filled with excitement. This will cause you to be restless and alert. Your heart rate will speed up, and you may even have butterflies in your stomach. Sound familiar? This is precisely the same response to the fear response. It's very clear to see the crossovers when you think about what gives some people thrills. A roller coaster can either be a thrilling or terrifying experience. The same could be said about skydiving or watching horror movies. Your response is determined by how you react to the situation.